living back in the day in Patterson, usually in the 1800s-ish, but it would be much larger as this small shuttle here. This is a hand loom, but they would have more of a computerized loom, and it would be this shuttle, which is much larger. And then instead of making the hand patterns, they would have this on the loom, and that would basically tell the machines how to make the pattern, which would end up sort of like this tapestry over here.
Wow.
So in the mid-1800s, Patterson was producing over half of the world's silk right here. So this was really the silk capital of the world at the time. And of course, they had to import the raw material. Couldn't quite manage to grow silkworms here, and the silk comes from the silkworm cocoon. So if that were to be crushed up, that's where they would get their silk from.
So do we have any industry that still produces the same thing in Patterson right now?
Not exactly like this today. There's not as much industry as there was back in the day, but silk was definitely the most prevalent industry here. This was very large. One of the last silk mills to close was in the 1980s. So starting from the late 1700s to then was rather a large feat.
Wow. Mm-hmm. So can you imagine somebody just like that every day inside Bill?
I mean, I'm in
building?
The shade right now. I can't imagine working in a big factory and also having an apron draped on you, because this was really the only clothing they had. So they had to keep it clean, the everyday worker.
And
yeah.
I believe there are certain speeds you have to keep working, a certain speed to
produce. You need to meet your quota for the day. That was big. So if I was working in a mill right now, I'm sure I'd be yelled at by the manager for going so slow. I should be done by now.
Thank you so much. Do you mind reminding us about your name again?
My name is Kelsey.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for visiting.
Yeah.